Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Again, this is Mr. Santos Capelan Jr. Always wishing you a good day. Now, today what I'm going to do is show you my control diagram for manual operation. Okay? Now, last tutorial, what I did was to give you an idea how are you going to prepare your power diagram. Okay, so please check that tutorial in my channel. Then today what I'm going to do is do the control diagram manual. Okay, because we can run this simple motor, okay, two fans in automatic and manual. Okay, now in manual operation, you will be the one to manually start or push the push button start. Okay, so the start push button, you will be the one to press it. Okay, so in manual operation, it will be operated by an individual. Now in automatic operation, I will try to connect this in building management system, so you will have an idea how are you going to prepare a automation for these two equipment. Okay, now okay, let me walk you through with my power diagram. As you can see here, I have here a circuit breaker, okay? So my line, okay, going to the primary side of my transformer. By the way, this is my control transformer, okay? So my control transformer, okay, so from 220, because my power supply is 220 single phase, okay? So from my 220, okay, I try to put a circuit breaker, okay? As you can see here, this is my circuit breaker, okay? Now it's on. So primary side 220, then secondary side of my transformer step down is 24 volts. Okay, so I tried to extend the 24 volts line, then the 0 volt line, or I can also call it neutral. Okay, so 24 volts, then 0 volts. Okay, now from 24 volts, what I did before I will connect it to my selector switch. Okay. By the way, my selector switch, okay, let me show you my selector switch, okay. When I say selector switch, this will be my selector switch, these two. Fan 1 selector switch, fan 2 selector switch, okay. So, before I will bring the 24 volts to the selector switch, okay. By the way, I'm showing you only one control diagram for one fan. Let's say this is fan number 1, okay. So before I will bring my 24 volts to my selector switch, but I have to provide one small fuse. Okay, so this will be my fuse. Okay, okay, where is it? Okay, so this is my fuse. So this is the one. So I have there around, I think, 1.5 amperes fuse. Okay, now let me go back to my. Okay, now okay, so my 24 volts, I put it in a fuse so that to protect my transformer if there in case there is a short in my control wiring. Okay, now so selector switch, there are three positions there: off, hand or manual, then automatic. Now I did the control wiring for the manual. Now first in my selector switch, okay, I connected one cable going to the stop push button, okay? Then the other side or the other terminal of the stop push button, I connect a wire going to the start push button, okay? Then from the other side of the terminal of this push button start, I connected the wire directly connected to the coil of the contactor. Now I already explained how the contactor works. There is a coil in a contactor. Now that coil, you need to energize or supply power to the coil so that the contacts will close. Okay, so from start other terminal, I connected one wire going to my A1 of my contactor coil. Then A2 will be connected to the normally close contact of overload. Okay, then it will be connected to neutral. Okay, so that is the connection in this first ladder. Or I can say this is the first ladder. Okay, now This contact is called latching contact, or latching contact. Okay, so the purpose of latching contact, since this start push button is only momentary, when we say momentary, when you press the start push button, it will be closed momentarily. But if you release the push button switch, then the contact will open again. So that our to provide a latching contact, because of course if you are going to run this in manual, you will not be going to stay in the control panel and keep on pressing the start button. So we are, to avoid that one, we are providing a latching contact. Okay, so latching contact, we try. So from this terminal of my start push button, I connected one wire, then I bring it to the normally open contact of my contactor. Then from the other side of this contact, I bring it to my A1. So meaning, when I push this, 24 volts will flow here. But if I release this one, since the normally open contact is already closed, okay, because the contactor, this normally open contact is coming from the contactor or auxiliary contact of the contactor. So when it closed, then when I release this, the flow of 24 volts is from this side. Okay? So it's just like a bridge or bypass. So 24 volts will go here, then it will keep on energizing your contactor. Then what happened next is I put one cable again in this side of this normally open contact, then I bring it to my lamp. Okay, because this lamp, you need to complete the circuit, you need to give 24 volts and connect it to common. So 24 volts and common or 0 volts. Okay, now from this side of the stop terminal, I connected one cable or one wire going to the normally open of my overload protection. Then it will go out of that contact. Okay, so this is actually in one contact, there are two terminals. So one terminal here and another terminal here. So from in this side, I connected the connected it to my lamp. Then the trip lamp is also connected to neutral. Okay, so the circuit is complete. So meaning, if it trips, this normally open contact will close. So 24 volts flow is from here, then trips, this one will close, then it will lit the trip lamp. Okay, now another one, I connected also this wire, I connected also to my power on. Power on, okay, so 24 volts from stop, then 24 volts, then neutral. So this lamp will be on if there is 24 volts. Okay, now as you can see here, stop push button is normally closed, as you can see in the diagram. So if you want to open this, you need to press the stop. Okay, so you will be cutting the 24 volts if you want to stop the fan. Okay, so from stop, connect one wire going to the terminal of the start push button, then the other pair of the terminal or other side of the terminal, connect one wire going to A1. Then provide the latching contact, which will pass in the normally open contact of the contactor, of this contactor, okay, to bypass during the releasing of the start push button, okay, or depressing of the start push button. Now the 24 volts will flow here, okay, energize this, then it will lit the run status, okay? So this is a very simple manual control diagram for one of the fans, okay? Now let me simulate, because I already did the connection. In my next tutorial, I will show you how I did the connection, okay? But to demonstrate my control logic based on the drawing, based on this control diagram, I will show you how to do this. Okay, now I already connected it. So first, as you can see here, my selector switch are still in an off position. Okay, so let me put it in a manual, the first one. Okay, so I put it in manual. So hand off, auto. Okay, so let me put both fans in out in manual. Okay, now, okay, so I want to run the fan manually. So all I need to do is push the start push button, okay? Okay, as you can see, the fan is already running, okay? The fan is running, okay? The fan is rotating now. Then, as you can see in my indication lamp, fan one run status is already lit, okay? So, it's working fine. Now, if I want to stop, all I need to do is push the stop push button. Okay, so it stopped. Now, let's try to run it again by pressing the start push button. Okay, as you can see, the contactor is energized. Okay, then at the same time, the lamps are lit for run status. Then power on is there. Okay, now I want to turn it off. Okay, as you can see, there is always power on there. That blue thing or the blue lamp, because my connection is 24 volts, 24 volts, okay? So 24 volts. So 24 volts will come here and it will be supplied in the lamp. Then it is connected to the 0 volts or neutral. That's why there is always light there. Okay, now let's try it again. Start. Okay, fan is running. Okay, now let's simulate that the fan trips. Okay, so what I will do, I will show you how to simulate the trip. Okay, so from here, okay, now I have here the trip or the test. Okay, so if you want to test this overload protection, you need to press this test. Okay, so let me do it. Wait, sorry. Okay, now I simulated the trip. Then as you can see, my trip lamp indication, as indicated by this red lamp, is lit. Okay, so meaning it's trip. Okay, so I can again reset it. I can reset it. Okay, so now the lamp indication is no longer there because I reset the trip. Okay, now let me start it again. Okay, as you can see, now I will try to trip it again, test the same procedure. Okay, as you can see, it trips and my fan is stopping now. Okay, so I will reset. So light indication for trip is gone. Okay, now so I will try to test both fans. Okay. Okay, as you can see now. Okay. So what is important here, guys, is the control wiring diagram. Because if you have your control wiring diagram, it's so easy to follow or do the actual connection. Now, my next tutorial, I will be showing you the actual how I wired it. So I will walk you through with the actual wiring. I will show you the back of this panel, how I connected the cable. We will try to trace again this control wiring diagram for manual operation. Okay. Now, let me show you these contactors. Now, I will try to trip both of the fans. Okay, both of the fans, I will try to trip. Test. Test. Okay, as you can see, both fans stops. Okay, then in my control panel, cover. Okay, so there is an indication of trip. Okay, so let me reset. Okay, reset. Okay, now again you can start it, just press the button, push button. Okay, so this is how are you going to prepare your control drawing in manual operation. Okay, so again, thank you very much for watching this short video clip. Watch out for my next tutorial, because I'm going to show you the actual connection of the control wiring in the indication lamp, selector switch, and start and stop push button switches. Okay, so once again, thank you for visiting my site, and I hope you already subscribe. And if not, please support my channel by subscribing. You can like and share my video, or you can always put a comment so we can discuss whatever query you have in your mind. So again, Santos Capilla Jr. saying God bless us all, and bye for now.